A little story about an ancient Chinese emperor. Thousands of years ago, in ancient China, a boy emperor ruled for a while. The imperial court had placed the child on the throne so that he could be a mouthpiece for the imperial court's desires. Coddled from birth, surrounded by servants and sycophants, told by the imperial court that he was the son of heaven, given to believe that he had no obligation to anyone but his imperial court, pampered and protected from any notion of what the real world was like, from any idea of what the people had to put up with every day. The emperor stomped and swaggered through the world, telling the people what to do, taking whatever he wanted, robbing from the poor, giving to the rich, and sending his armies out to terrorize whomever he took a notion to despise. The emperor ruled for a long time, and thousands of people died, killed by his armies and because of his abuse and neglect. But eventually, after great suffering, the people rose up and crushed the man who called himself the Son of Heaven. And they crushed his imperial court as well. Then, some time passed, in which the people lived in relative calm, until another emperor, like the one in this story, came along. from fear. May I be filled with loving kindness.
Beside river and sign. Oh.
never stopping day or night. Confucius stood beside a river and sighed. Our lives pass on like this, never stopping day or night. Itself until it joins itself and makes beginning end. It makes a circle, not a line, and held within that closure is the crush of breaths and flesh that we all are, turning in the turning year, bending as all breaths bend toward the dead, our flesh toward soil. Every year the world dies and comes alive again. It renews itself over and over again and again, forever. Around and around we also go, but where we stop, we all know. Bending as all breaths bend toward the dead, our flesh toward soil. Tomorrow, we are bones and ash, the roots and weeds poking through our skulls. But today is our life. Today, we want to go for a walk in the sun, play music and sing, sit down and eat, rise up and dance. It's time for life. It's time to till the soil and plant a garden. Time to sit in the afternoon and drink tea. Time to make love. Time to visit with friends. It's time for music and dancing. It's not time for war. It's not time for war. It's not time for war and killing. We want to live. Prime ministers, presidents, despots, dictators, tyrants, terrorists. We don't want to fight your war. We want to eat and love and dance. We want to lie down and die in our own good time. Let us die our own natural deaths, old and weazened, crippled and suffering. But let us die our own natural deaths. We don't want to fight your wars. Don't let us die from your bullets and bombs. Don't let us die from your fire and poison gas. Let us die in peace, in the peace of a our own old age. Let us all grow old and die in peace. Let us die in peace. We don't want to fight your war. It's not time for war and killing. It's not time for war and killing. Let us die in peace, in the peace of our own age. We want to live. Let us live. Our own age. road of this life is long and hard, full of doubts and regrets. And at the end, no reward, only death. That's all we get. We might as well love this life while we can. Have a cup of tea, visit with a friend. The last lines of chapter 81 of Lao Tzu's Tao Te Ching say, their food is plain and good, and they enjoy eating it. Their clothes are simple and beautiful. Their home is secure. They are happy in their ways. Though they live within sight of their neighbors, and their chickens and dogs call back and forth, they leave each other in peace. As they grow old and die, just think what a good time we all could have. How much of the world we could notice if we were happy to be who we are and we left each other in peace. How Buddha talked me out of monastic renunciation. Siddhartha Gautama said, forsaking loved one, renouncing delight, determined to seek a heavenly bliss, you might avoid some sufferings, but not the great one in the end. So, why not have a mate? Make some kids, build a house, cultivate a garden, get together with your friends, play some music, drink some tea. If we only could have peace. Imagine your body on fire. Imagine your arm blown away. Imagine your hands off there, somewhere, lying around on the lawn. Imagine your body in pieces, scattered across a Baghdad street. Imagine yourself crawling around, trying to find your feet. Imagine your corpse on a road somewhere out in the country in Iraq, under the midday sun. How can we do this to these people? What did they do to us? What could be more important than this life, my life, your life, their life, our lives? What could be more important than our days here on this earth? What could be more important than the end of this life toward which we all hurry? Confucius stood beside a river and sighed. We pass on like this, never stopping day or night. What is ambition compared to death? How can greed and the will to power compete with our own dying? Who needs war in this life? We have pain and suffering enough. How can we do this to these people? what did they do to us? Hansan says, both life and death are fine. How does he know? Has he been dead? I know a lot about life. I don't know squat about death. I like life. I like it a lot. I'd like to keep on living forever. What do I know about death? I don't think I'm going to like death. Either one is not fine with me. And no Chinese wise guy from 1,000 years ago can convince me otherwise. How can we do this to these people? What did they do to us? Isa said, still clothed in the dust of the suffering world, I will celebrate. Can we do that? Is it possible to celebrate at a time like this? In this suffering world? Can we praise our lives? Can we praise this life? Can we praise this life as we shuffle toward our graves? Tomorrow, we are bones and ash, the roots of weeds poking through our skull. Today, simple clothes, empty mind, full stomach, alive, aware, right here, right now. Drunk on music, who needs wine? Oh, come on, sweetheart. Let's go dance while we've still got feet. Thank you. On a summer day in 1969, at the age of 29, having known riots, assassinations, wars, near anarchy loosed upon the streets, bedlam on the ship of state, I jumped overboard and swam all the way up here to Judevine Mountain, to where, as Han Solomon said, I thought I might dwell and gaze in freedom. I gave up life in the city and exiled myself into these mountains, thinking I might find here a more civil, decent, kind, human, and humane way to live my life. It's more than 30 years later now, and even though I live among these cliffs, hidden by the clouds, among bird songs, forest walks, and kind people. Still, I know it is impossible to leave my country. There is still nowhere I can hide from the way the emperor and his bullies. Up on the world.
Thank you.
if a bodhisattva is one who, although enlightened, chooses to remain here in this suffering world and be with the suffering people. Then there is no escape for any of us. Since how could we gain enlightenment by running away from the pain and injustice that is all around us? To decide simply to remove yourself from the fray, to sit down and find peace at the center of a storm by ignoring the causes of that storm, can't possibly be a way to any understanding. For if such is impossible for a bodhisattva, how much more impossible for the temporal, gross, and worldly likes of you and me? Thank you. Says you are evil. The emperor declares himself and his friends good. The emperor says, as soon as good has destroyed evil, all will be good. Simple as 1, 2, 3, clear as night and day, different as black and white, easy as pie. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Assalamu alaikum. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Assalamu alaikum, Iraq. Wa alaikum. Wa alaikum salam. Assalamu alaikum. I don't want to fight your war. I want to make the bed. I don't want to fight your war. I want to make cookies. I don't want to fight your war. I want to make love. I don't want to fight your war. I want to make it over to my friend's house. I don't want to fight your war. I want to make a poem. I don't want to fight your war. I want to make it to work tomorrow. I don't want to fight your war. I want to make a salad. This is from Trappist monk, poet, peace activist, Thomas Merton. There is in all visible things an invisible fecundity, a dimmed light, a meek namelessness, a hidden wholeness. There is in all things an inexhaustible sweetness and purity, a silence that is the fountain of action and joy. It rises up in wordless gentleness and flows out to me from unseen roots of all created being. It's beginning again. The pavilion of good crops and peace is about to decorate itself again. The hills are about to turn green. Soon the garden will be full of young shoots. Soon the sun will be high and warm. Soon countless generations of wildflowers will come and go in the leafless woods. I can hear music coming from the pavilion. It floats on the air like apple blossoms falling, like spring birds singing in mid-air. The peas and beans, the young maple leaves are singing. Warmth and peace, life, life to all that grows. But there is no peace and no electricity, no water, no civil government, no law, no order. No food, stores looted and empty, markets looted and empty, museums and libraries looted and empty. These gifts from the American liberators. On the ruined streets of Baghdad, a woman says, George Bush, why, George Bush, why? It became necessary to destroy the village in order to save it. Yet the music still comes. It floats on the air. The peas and beans, the young maple leaves, will not quit singing. They will not give up their song. Warmth and peace, life to all that grows. Warmth and peace, life. Life to all that grows. Let us raise the flag of human suffering. We want to live, let us live. Warmth and peace, life, life to all that grows. The Bhagavad Gita says, whatever you do, make it an offering to me. The food you eat, the worship you perform, the help you give, even your suffering, and the music you play. away the poems we write. Buddha was right. Life is suffering. And because it is, because we are here and we suffer, we can know the suffering of others. And because we can know the suffering of others, we can raise the flag of human suffering. We can light the fire of compassion within ourselves. The fire of compassion for all the suffering in this world. Light the fire of compassion. Raise the flag of human suffering. We want to live. Let us live. Light the fire of compassion. Raise the flag of human suffering. We want to live. Let us live. peaceful and strong.
May all abide in equal view.
May I be free from fear,
not caught up in loss and gain.
May I be filled with loving kindness.
Through this great wish for every being, may I know their hearts as mine.
May you be peaceful and happy.
May all beings have happiness.
May you be healthy and strong. May you be free from fear.
May all beings be free from suffering and the causes of their pain.
May you be filled with loving kindness.
May all abide in equal view.
May presidents and prime ministers,
not caught up in loss and gain,
dictators and despots,
through this great wish for every being, may
tyrants and terrorists,
as mine,
be peaceful and happy.
May all beings have happiness.
May they be healthy and strong. May presidents and prime ministers.
May all beings be free from suffering and the causes of their pain.
Dictators and tyrants.
Flowers
and terrorists.
Grow.
May all of us
be free from fear.
Not caught up in loss and gain.
May they be filled with love.
Through this great wish for every being.
When I hear a loud explosion,
I hear a loud explosion.
May all beings have happiness.
The smoke of human tragedy fills my lungs.
May all beings be
free from suffering. The smoke from the burning crosses in Mississippi and Alabama. The smoke of Hiroshima, Johannesburg, Auschwitz, Wounded Knee, and Baghdad. The smoke of lies,
through this
broken treaties, racism, and hate.
I know their hearts is mine.
Om Janadakini Bamhadini Sasidi.
What is the difference between a soldier and a murderer? What is the difference between a soldier and a terrorist? What is the difference between a terrorist and a murderer? What is the difference between a terrorist and a soldier? How can I tell the difference? How can you tell the difference?
May all beings be free from suffering and the causes of the.
Please send tears to put out the fire of death.
Assalamu alaikum, Your Majesty.
Please send tears to put out the fire of death.
Assalamu alaikum.
May the fire of compassion rain on all human beings, now and forever.
May the fire of compassion rain down on all human beings.
Please send tears
down
to put out the fire of death.
Please send down the tears to put out
light the fire of compassion.
May the fire of compassion rain down on all human beings now and forever.
Please send tears to put out
light the fire of compassion.
Please send tears to put out
raise the flag of human suffering.
May all beings be free from suffering.
Let us live. We want to live.
Light
let us
fire of compassion. We want to live.
Not caught up in
let us live.
Assalamu alaikum.
Life. 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 To all that grows.
200 years ago, Isa heard the morning birds singing sutras to this suffering world. I heard them too this morning.
Rain,
which must mean, since we will always have a suffering world
and forever,
we must also always have
rain,
a song.
Human being now and forever. Rain down on all human beings.
Now, raise the flag.
us human suffering. Tears to put out the fire,
like the fire of the ash
fire.
Warmth and peace, life. To all that grows.
May all beings have happiness and the causes of pure joy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Assalamu alaikum. William Parker. Hamid Drake. Thank you all.
One second.